गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट द रिवीजन, फर्स्ट रिवीजन क्लास रिगार्डिंग आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर रिप्रोडक्शन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म, वेयर वी हैव गॉट अबाउट द लाइफ स्पैन प्रोसेस, डिफरेंट स्टेजेस, जुवेनाइल फेज, मैच्योरिटी, सेनेसेंस. देन वी हैव कम अक्रॉस डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव प्रोसेसेस, एसेक्सुअल, वेजिटेटिव, सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. Different processes are involved, how examples are given for each type. So all these things we have come across it, and even the events of sexual reproduction. So I hope everything is clear to you. So you have already got a set of question papers. So now let's discuss the questions from there. Okay, the first question, which are immortal organisms? Explain how. That means the unicellular organisms are called immortal organisms because the parent cell divides into two daughter cells and the daughter cell acts as the new cell. So the parent cell does not die. So that is the immortal organisms. What is a clone? The morphologically and genetically similar organisms are called clone. Which kind of reproduction can produce them? Asexual reproduction. Okay, now how these organisms are asexually or vegetatively reproduced? Now for amoeba binary fission, yeast budding, bacteria binary fission, amoeba binary fission, chlamydomonas by sporulation, formation of zoospores, penicillium by conidia, hydra budding, sponge gamule, potato tuber, ginger rhizome, agave by bulbils, bryophyllum by leaves, hyacinth, that is water hyacinth, by offset, sugarcane, stem cuttings, dahlia by roots. So these are the different methods of propagation. What is terror of Bengal? Water hyacinth, Iconia crassipes, is called the terror of Bengal. It is so called because it is a very invasive weed. When grows in water, it takes off all the oxygen from water, which in other words harm the aquatic life, that is the plants and animals living in the water will be in deficit of oxygen. For that's why that is known as the terror of Bengal. Which part of plant is related to vegetative reproduction? Root, stem, leaf, buds, these are related to vegetative reproduction because in these parts there is no any other method of reproduction, but sexual reproduction is not at all possible in these parts. So vegetative reproduction is the only method. Which mode of reproduction is used by algae and fungi to increase their population? Asexual method. When did algae and fungi are involved in sexual reproduction, and explain why? When the situation is adverse conditions come, they are involved in sexual reproduction because we already know that due to sexual reproduction, variation occurs. So when variation is there, they can adapt to the changing situation or the adverse condition. So for that particular reason, they just get involved in the sexual reproduction. What are monocarpic plants? The plants which flower only once in their lifetime is called monocarpic plant. Example, bamboo. List out the major events along with their sub-events of sexual reproduction. First is pre-fertilization event. Then it is subdivided into gametogenesis and gamete transfer, fertilization and post-fertilization, which is subdivided again into zygote formation and embryogenesis. Okay. Both cucurbita and papaya are unisexual flowers, but they have different in their sexuality. Now, papaya is a dioecious plant. That means the plant here, both the male and female flowers are born in different plant. That is, the male plant is different, female plant is different. But in cucurbita, it is a monoecious plant. That means both the male and female flowers are born in the same plant, but they are unisexual. So their sexuality is different. That is, one is monoecious plant and one is dioecious plant, but altogether, these are they bear unisexual flowers. Okay, how gametogenesis of cladophora is different from that of fucus? Now, we already know that what is gametogenesis? The process of formation of gametes. Now, in cladophora, homogametes are formed. That means the process in which similar type of gametes are formed, it is homogametes, which is found in cladophora, and in fucus heterogametes are formed. That means the gamete formation process where different types of gametes are formed. Okay. How homothelic species differ from heterothelic species in fungi? In homothelic fungi, the functional gametes belong to the same parent and there is no morphological or physiological difference. For example, mucor mucedo. But in heterothallic fungi, the functional gametes come from different parents. Male parent, female parents are different, or whatever we call it as plus strain, minus strain. And they are morphologically and physiologically not different. Okay? That is similar point in both, but the thing is that one comes from same parent, other comes from different parent. For example, Rhizopus stolonifer. Okay. In what are hermaphrodites? That is the organism in which both male and female sex organs are present. Example, earthworm or leech, whatever you feel comfortable, you can give. Meiosis is interlinked with which kind of reproduction? Sexual reproduction. Why? Because if meiosis occurs, the chromosome number reduces to half. That is, N chromosome numbers are formed. And we know the organisms are twice N. So in fertilization process, N and N will combine together to form the zygote. And so for sexual reproduction, meiosis is very much essential in order to maintain the twice N chromosome number. How syngamy differs from fertilization? Syngamy means the basic process of fusion of the gametes, and fertilization means the whole sum of events which takes place, including syngamy. What is parthenogenesis? The process of in which the egg develops into an individual without fertilization. That is called parthenogenesis. Example, honeybee, which reproduce only by parthenogenesis. Okay, how external fertilization is different from internal fertilization? External fertilization, in which the gametes are released from outside the body of the organism in a medium, for example, water. Internal fertilization, here the gametes fuse in the body of the female organism. So that is called internal fertilization. Example, external frog, fish, internal human beings, flowers, angiospermic flowers. Okay, what is embryogenesis? Embryogenesis means the process of formation of embryo from a diploid zygote. Which organism does not exhibit it in their life cycle? Algae. Algae doesn't show embryogenesis. Explain two pathways of embryogenesis occurring in organisms, ovipary and vivipary, organisms lay their young once eggs are laid, and the other where the young ones are given birth. So these are the two pathways. Okay, which part of the flower develop into seed and pericarp? Seed is developed from the mature ovule and pericarp from the wall of the ovary. Okay, so now we have came across all these questions. Again, if you have anything, any difficulty in writing the answers, you prepare this. Study the book, go through the questions. These are just reference questions. So everything is important. And if there is any problem, please consult.